You my brother. I'm your brother. You should protect, you protecting his dude. Yeah. He's a punk. That's why Jen left him. Jen like that. Jen do that type of stuff. She bisexual stuff. But now he want her to stop. He don't want to do it no more. So he want her not to do it no more. She like, no, this is me. You do this when you met me. You came into my circle. You know, and I respect Jim, but Jim is 100. She ain't gonna lie to you. She called me, because she was like, I know Twitter did everything for you, Frank. As long as I know you, I know what he did. You know, he was always there. Sheriff never came over there before she went to work. Beaver didn't either. I'm steady feeding them. I leave an hour early just to make sure mom and daddy got breakfast cleaned up, fold. He wouldn't even fold daddy's clothes. Get those daddy clothes in the ball in the room, in the other room. He did the same with mom. Yeah. Well, they can fold their own goddamn clothes. Why can't they fold? It's just out of, you know, out of courtesy, man. Nothing. But he want to catch out of the cloud like I was trying to tell Uncle Mike and Aunt Cookie. Don't believe everything he say. Be a compulsive liar. If we got a lie detector machine, he will blow it up. You can ask me anything. I can put my hand on the Bible. Ask me any question, and I'll tell you the truth. But I got a lie. I've been working on it. Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
This was so fucking funny.
It's like that. He know that's wrong. But I get it. If I didn't love my kids and my grandbaby so much, I'd kill both of them.
Yeah.
I sure would. I'd kill both of them. I'd kill that nigga first and drag his ass outside, leave him in the middle of that street. And I'd drive right over there and do the same with her and set their weight on the police. I ain't scared of no jail. I ain't scared of no damn police. They are, though. But they so bad. They want you to get outside your character. Talk all that noise. Soon you finna whoop that butt. Now they wanna call 911. That's their toughness. Listen to Sheriff. Sheriff can't fight. People can't fight. People ain't won not a fight he had. Only reason why niggas in the hood didn't mess with him because of us. We had to do his fight. And we tell them, bro, leave that dude alone, man. That dude ain't studying. He looking at me. How you know he looking at you if you not looking at him? Yeah. Quit looking over there. Quit being messy. Yeah. You gonna make me fight a dude because you being ignorant. I know you wrong. I know how you are. You petty. Him and Cheryl want you on their side. You not on their side, they not gonna talk to you. And he know this girl. This girl does not care about him. At all. When he come to the hospital to see this dude. Every time daddy went to the hospital, none of them would go. They wait till I get them in a room or something. They want to stay at home, drink their beer, stay with their buddy. Nigga, I want to stay at home too. You here. Why you can't ride with us? I go every time I see. Daddy was so happy to see me. He never got a smile when Beaver opened his door. You looking at him like, nigga, what you want? You know, why are you here? 2 weeks, a month before daddy died, he was waiting all this fuss. I'm tired of this shit, I'm gonna leave. Daddy said, nigga, leave. It's my house. Leave. I said, nigga, what's going on? I said, daddy, did he hit you? He said, no, that motherfucker ain't crazy. I didn't hear him. I say, man, I'm gonna tear your ass up.
Oh, yeah. I know you are.
Don't you ever think about hitting my dad. That's why I don't know if he pushed him. Lonnie told me one day when daddy broke his back, how he picked him up and threw him on the bed and stuff. I said, bro, Lonnie wanted to get him. I said, how you just now you want to get in front of Aunt Cookie Nim and everybody? You were so concerned, son. Sure, too. That shit kills me. And I know why they're doing it because they feel guilty. Because they know they didn't do what they should have been doing. But But now you want to run everything. You ain't did nothing, ain't tried to open no bills or pay. Lying to everybody talking about he been paying the bill. Only bill that boy recently started paying the electric bill and the cable bill. He never paid no house note. He never paid no insurance on the house. None of that. He never paid a water bill, gas bill, none of that. All he paid was a cable bill and the electric bill. That's it. The last year. That's only. When I and them left that house, that's when he started paying. When I and them was there, he wasn't paying nothing.
Yes, indeed. He's a
wrong
man.
Yeah, he's a double child. Him and Cheryl is a double child. They got black hearts. But I tell you, if they wasn't no kin to me, I'll be waiting on y'all to come at me, because I tell his ass up. Excuse my name. I would tow him up. He getting no more passes though. I don't care. Don't even come over. He's not welcome in my house. I don't want that negative energy he got. And Cheryl, I don't want it. Stay over there, man. You want the house, he can have it. I won't even come over there anymore. My mom and daddy gone. You want him to be Mr. Big Shot? Be Mr. Big Shot. Tomorrow his ass will be in the dark with the electricity in my name. His ass ain't gonna have no water because the water in my name. His ass ain't gonna have no gas because the gas in daddy's name. He won't have no cable TV because the cable TV is in daddy's name.
Wow.
So I'm setting everything down. When your ass.
Yes.
Set it all down on his ass.
When it all shut down, you're gonna have to pick a house to get it off.
Oh yeah. Oh yes. I'm gonna call the water people and tell them. I'm gonna tell them everything. I don't live there no more. Shut it down. My daddy died, shut it down today. I don't want no week or nothing. Stop it today. And mail a bill to me. I will pay that balance and he can have the rent. He get it in the morning.
Yeah.
I got it the cheapest, man. I got it for, you don't pay no more than $70 a month on my life. But I gave them people so much headache. If my dad and mama is here by themselves, and I know they ain't giving them that much. $300-$500. Let's get one of them bills. He worried about his money. He's spending too much. What you spending money on? On punks, crackheads. You'll buy a crackhead. You give a crackhead some money to buy her baby some diapers, knowing she ain't going to buy the baby no diapers. She's going to smoke some. You want to buy your niece baby no diapers. Come on, man. That nigga's jealous of me. He's been jealous of me ever since I was a little boy. Because mom and daddy, he wondered why mom and daddy chose me. They chose me because they knew you wasn't man material.
Yeah,
that's what it was. Can't stand up and look at that from the chair. You gonna go against you, chair? Chair? She know, mama, dad know I'm about the right thing. I ain't gonna do nothing wrong. Why I'm gonna do, that's what they hate. I won't commit with them to do the wrong thing. That don't make sense. You smiling in this man's face. Now you talking behind the back. Then, I know he talking about me. He gonna come to me, you hear anything, man. I ain't saying nothing. I know you didn't say this, bro, because you're a coward. Now you coming to me. You coming to me now trying to put it out that, you know, to cover yourself. But you, it came out your mouth, bro. I know. I said, man, I don't care what anybody say about me. You know why? Because I'm a man, and they can't put their hands on me. You got in the crowd with me. Come to me as a man, put your hands on me, we're gonna find out what's real or not. I'm my mama's child and my daddy's son. Try me. I'm gonna show you something. And he know that. That's why they hate me, because I don't need a crowd to stand. I don't need a posse. I need a posse grabbing up people to come. Come at me, bring anybody you want to. I'm gonna put it all on your back. Next. I'm hollering next. Who next? Next. See, once I knock that person out, ain't nobody coming. I'm my daddy's son. I finally thought I had a brother, a big brother. You know, he wanted me, he never wanted me to succeed at nothing. But God always blessed me because I'm always there for my mom and my dad. My mom and dad, they still blessing me today. They gave me a good job the other day, last week. I made $1,600 a week now. They gave me an extra $1,000 a week. For 4 hours a day, working in a 18-wheeler truck for them. And I was like, that ain't nothing but God right there. Pleading with me like you've been doing ever since Daddy died, but you started doing the opposite thing. You started doing what I'm accusing you of. So, yes. But you trying to cover it up like you not, and I'm not understanding. I say, you think I'm stupid or something. You really think I'm stupid? I said, I'm my mama's child and my daddy's son. Why do you keep saying that? I said, because you not. Why you think they chose me? They pulled me in that room as a little boy and groomed me for this. Even with Michael. They didn't trust you with Michael. I took Michael to the doctor's appointment.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, Mama, why I got to do this? Get in the car, boy. I get in the car. You know, I'm going to go hang with my boy. But I always, they understood, hey man, I gotta go do this. I gotta do that. All right, Kate, we be here, man. Hurry back. Beaver wasn't in the streets. Beaver didn't know nothing about the streets. He was an oddball ball out. He liked a white one trapped in a black boy's body. Everybody, what's wrong with your brother? He know everybody know the word. I know he ain't my brother. He my half brother. But he's not my true brother.
Yes, indeed, sir.
I knew. Mom and dad tell me, don't you say that no more. He's your brother now. I knew. I said, Mom, he don't act like us. Daddy, he don't act like us. You know. But all them other boys, we can. Yeah. He was soft. He didn't do the things we did. And you never had that vibe with him. We know the stuff about the Papa. This nigga, like a white boy, he walked right into fire. Like he don't even know. Bro, you don't see this dude over there? Come here, man. We trying to get him out the way. You see the dude about to set it out, got a pistol. He finna do something. You walk right over that bar and be like, hey. You know, he's like, nigga, you got to pay attention. I can read people when they come in. I'm looking at this dude. We just know, hey, man, we all of me, Derek, Ryan, and Bert, we look at each other like, hey, hands up. Not this nigga. Why y'all running? What's he running for? Run, nigga.
If I'm running, you can't
running. You can ask questions later. We got to get you. I saved his life. I saved Cheryl's life. Boy had the knife to. She called me. She can cuss mom and dad out. We ain't seen in 2 weeks. I got off on a Friday. Me and my boys, we gonna hook up. I'm going to the Bristol, ice it up. I look at my phone, it's her. And I'm like, I ain't gonna answer. And something just told me I had this strange feeling to answer it, bro. You know, I answered. She crying. Please come over. Please come here. Please, I need you. I'm right. I'm like, where you at? I'm on Park Lane. I said, well, I'm gonna bring her. I'm like 5 minutes from you. What apartment you at? She gave an apartment. I get over there. Some told me I'm getting out of the car. Some told me, get your gun. I got my gun, put it in my bag. I'm walking, looking for an apartment. I come up on, I hear some screaming. I look, I see two people sitting on the couch. I see her in the kitchen with the dude. The dude got a knife to the throat. I come up over that patio, come slam that patio door open. They told that Negro, do it, cut up, and now his brother and sister hollering, but you're not hollering when he got the knife to him, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I'm like, cut her, bro, I want you to. No, wait, it's just a misunderstanding. I said, oh, yeah, it's a misunderstanding, cut her. I want you to, I'm gonna give you this gift.
Chocolate chip.
He gave her to me. His brother and sister, and on the phone with the police. I said, yo, call the police. Next thing I know, when I grabbed her, he take off running. I set the patio door when I came in, but I didn't want nobody to run out. That fool ran right up to that door, man. Hard, bam, and landed on his back. And she hollered, I better shoot him then, shoot him right in his head. And she hollered, no, brother, please, do you know? The nigga got up, opened the door, ran out. By this time, the police came. I told him what went down. I said, you should have shot him. I would have shot this nigga. Two black cops. He said, you would have went to jail, but you would have got off on this one. But I would have shot this nigga. And they kept telling me. They let me go. Let me take her home. Took her home to mama. She crying, cracking her ideas, how sorry she was. A week later, she ran back with the nigga. Left the house again. Yep. And then a couple of months later, somebody killed the dude.
Yes,
sir. Yeah, somebody killed her. Then she started messing with y'all. Yeah. Oh, yeah, they killed him. They killed him. They killed him downtown. They sure did. Well, shot his butt up. I said, see, I didn't even have to kill him. What we find like Charles ain't faithful to this girl. I don't blame him though, because she's terrible. She's hard. I don't even know how he living with her. That girl is so controlling. Like I told Chris, I said, you need to get out of there. I talked to him yesterday. I said, man, your mama is not no good mama. And you need to, you too grown, you need to get your own life. You had your own house. She wouldn't want you to have your house. That's why she broke you and your girlfriend up to make you come home to abide by her rules.
Yeah, stay with her.
Yeah, Patrick is messed up because of her, ain't he? Patrick had a shitty mama and a shitty dad that didn't care about nothing but themselves. They ruined that boy. That boy, if he had any other parents, if he was my son, he wouldn't be the way he is right now. I guarantee you that.
Yeah.
Cheryl built that boy that way.
Yeah.
Yeah. That boy got a black heart too. She cut that boy cuss her out, call her bees and hoes and all type of stuff. And she sad and crying. I said, that's what you mean. You sold that.
Yeah, she did that.
You made that boy that way. I don't blame him at all. He just was dealt a wrong hand, man. He was born in prison. You know, me and Beaver and Mama raised him from 2 days old till he was 2 and a half. walked in, teased, everything, out of diapers. Then she come home. Yeah. I said, why you don't see no baby pictures of you and your mama? Because your mama was in jail.
Don't tell him that.
He didn't even know the truth. Chris didn't even know. I told Chris. I told Chris yesterday. He wasn't for it. You were born in prison. Do you think she got any gratefulness toward us for taking care of her? I almost flunked out of high school because I had to miss so many days to take care of this boy. Me and Beaver had to alternate.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. Just leave them alone, man. You know, I'm gonna stay out their way, but if they come over here or they come and try to do anything to me, I'll bet y'all, I'm gonna protect myself. Cause I'm my mama's child, my daddy's son. I ain't gonna go try to get at them. But they come to me any type of way they go, I'm gonna put the pain on them. If I don't kill them, they gonna know. They gonna know.
Oh, man.
Get that garage, boy.